Welcome to your social studies class.
Hello students, my name is Rupali, your social studies teacher from Elite American Corporate School, Patiala. So students, please tell me, are you enjoying your social studies lecture? Okay, and I think you will enjoy more and more in coming days. Okay? So, all have you done your homework? My name is Rupali, your social studies teacher. How are you all? Very nice. Have you all done your homework? Very good. And who can tell me what we have covered in our last lecture? Please tell me the chapter number. Yes. We have covered chapter number 2, part 2 and topic, yes, we have covered public health care services and private health care services. So students, today we are going to discuss our new topic and this is the last topic of this chapter and the topic is healthcare and equality and healthcare remedies. So today we will cover healthcare and equality and healthcare remedies.
Health care and equality. In the last few decades, we have seen a remarkable growth in private health services, especially in urban areas, as their prime objective is to earn profit. The cost of services is very high, and it makes it out of bounds for the common people. Medicines have become so expensive that often illness in the family becomes a cause of worry. Health care and equality. In the last few decades, we have seen a remarkable growth in private health services, especially in urban areas. As their prime objective is to earn profit, the cost of services is very high and it makes it out of bounds for the common people. Medicines have become so expensive that often illness in the family becomes a cause of worry. Doctors and hospitals too engaged in unfair practices and encourage the most expensive treatment for the patients, putting patients at the heart of everything we do. H stands for honest, E stands for equality, A stands for accountability, R stands for respect, and T stands for teamwork. In fact, only a very limited section of the society can afford medicines that one requires during illness, and it is also a cause of rural family debt in India. 40% of the population admitted in hospital for some ailment has to take a loan or put up for sale some position to pay for the treatment. It causes suffering for even those who do not fall in the category of poor. Even though private health facilities are costly. A majority of the population prefer their services as they give better medical care and the surrounding is cleaner as compared to public health services. For the poor, it is a major cause of worry and anguish. This is because due to poverty, they are malnourished, do not have access to the basic amenities, which is good food, clean drinking water, hygienic environment, and so they have the probability of falling sick more often. The costs incurred on sickness worsen their condition, and since it occurs frequently, the problems are compounded. Unhygiene is our silent enemy. Just finished it silently. In addition to lack of funds, there are other reasons that prevent people from getting appropriate medical attention. Women's health continues to be neglected in many parts of the country. They do not get prompt medical attention. There is a need to change the mindset of the people too. In rural areas, people still feel more comfortable in visiting village doctors rather than qualified medical practitioners. Healthcare remedy. Thus, it is quite apparent from the above discussion that health situation in our country needs to be improved. For that, the government has to play a proactive role to provide essential healthcare facilities in the remotest part of the country. However, as mentioned earlier, health is also dependent upon hygienic surroundings, pollution-free environment, and clean drinking water. Clean drinking water. Keep your surroundings pure and clean. This hygiene will keep you healthy physically and mentally. The Costa Rican approach. Costa Rica, a country of South America, approached health issues which became an example for every developing country. Long back, the government of this country decided to dismantle its army. The money spent on it was to be used on health, education, and other basic needs of the countries. Later, the government made an arrangement to provide basic services and amenities like safe drinking water, sanitation, nutrition, and housing. Today, they have been able to become one of the healthiest countries of South America. Thank you, students. Stay safe, stay healthy, and enjoy the video.